What's happening, guys? Keith here with your December 9th edition of the Impact Report. If you haven't checked out my review of this past week's episode of Impact already, you can do so by clicking the link at the top of the screen. And speaking of this past week's episode of Impact, it drew 116,000 viewers and ranked 150 on Cable's Top 150. This is 5% down from last week's 122,000 viewers. However, last week's episode did not rank in Cable's Top 150, which is why the viewership numbers were delayed. This week's episode did draw a 0.04 rating in the 18 to 49 demographic. This week's show showcased two qualifying Ultimate X matches for Homecoming, along with the main event of Johnny and Taya versus Moose and Tessa Blanchard. Heading over to Impact's YouTube page to see the highest viewed highlights from this past week's episode. Number 3, Ali and Soo Young destroy Kiera Hogan. This had 48,000 views. Number 2, Raven helps Eddie Edwards escape the insane asylum. This had 64,000 views. And number 1, Brian Cage saves Johnny and Taya from Doomsday. This had 274,000 views, which is one of the highest viewed clips in quite some time for recent Impact stuff. So that was really good to see, since that is, well, Brian Cage and Johnny Impact is going to be the main event of Homecoming, so it does look like people are interested in that, which is very good to hear. The lowest viewed clip from this past week's episode was Scarlett Bordeaux has high hopes for the Rascals. This only had 12,000 views. There was a couple other clips that were hovering around this point, like the Desi Hit Squad and then Eli Drake reading the note from Abyss. So I'm going to do something a little different. Normally, I would do a separate video for my Xplosion review, so I'm going to actually include that in this week's episode and probably going to keep it on Sunday's Impact Report heading forward or moving forward. So this Xplosion was from last weekend. It's dated December 1st. However, it usually doesn't air until Monday or Tuesday, so that was the 3rd when it aired. This match was from the Mexico City tapings. There was actually no Impact talent featured on this week's Xplosion match. It was actually 6 local talents from Mexico City. The match was Dragon Bane, Starfire, and Aramis versus Arez, Chica Tormenta, and Latigo. Josh made mention that this is the first ever Xplosion match to take place in Mexico, and this was a Lucha Libre intergender match, so the men can legally face the women. I know intergender wrestling is usually a hot topic among wrestling fans. It was interesting to note, a lot of people complain about the believability factor, but there were a few times when some of the men were no-selling the offense by the much smaller woman in Starfire, so that was interesting to see. But yeah, this match was a lot of fun. Very fast-paced. A lot of great spots, you know, really what you would expect from Lucha Libre wrestling. I was really impressed with what I saw from Dragon Bane. Very fluid, walked the ropes almost like Phoenix. I did some research on him, and I found out that he recently had a WWE tryout in Chile. I was really hoping to see him in action when Impact goes back to Mexico in early 2019, but we will see. There was also a couple other talents that recently got a tryout that were showcased on Impact's when they were in Mexico on the normal Impact tapings. I also liked what I saw from Aramis. He hit a beautiful Swanton bomb to the outside. At one point, Arez was standing on the apron, and Aramis was jumped over the top ropes, diving into Arez, and he turned it into a Spanish fly on the other 4 competitors on the outside. Just a great spot. The crowd got super into it. But the finish saw Aramis put Arez in a torture rack position. He does a few airplane spins, dropping him down. Dragon Bane from the top hits Arez with a 630 for the victory. So like I said, this was a fun match. Much different than what we usually get on Xplosion, and it was good to see some other talents. I would definitely recommend checking this out if you have the GWN. I mean, the match was only about 9 minutes long. It's funny, on Twitter, Garrett Kidney, I believe he's the social media guy for Impact, but he posted a clip from this episode, and you had people asking when Xplosion was uploaded to YouTube, but he told them it's not, it's a GWN exclusive. But I really think that is a place Impact should think about airing Xplosion later on down the line, but we'll see. We got a video then for the One Night Only Back to Cali, which was recorded last weekend, I believe, and it airs December 21st on the GWN. I thought the video they did previewing the show was really well done. That video is available on Impact's YouTube page if you guys want to check that out. I would like to see it aired during Impact. I mean, that also pushes people to join the GWN to be able to see these events. But and then we had Around the Ring featuring Tessa Blanchard. This was good. I enjoyed this. This is Tessa's first time on the show. As in the beginning, she joked about blowing Josh off and not coming on the show. She says she loves the West Coast and is considering moving there. She says she's been really busy with wrestling. She hasn't been home in 3 months, but she's been having fun and is excited for this part of her career. She's excited for the holidays and spending time with her family, which she didn't get to do last year. She loves flying with Delta as they constantly upgrade her and treat her well. Her family will be at homecoming, and it'll be the first time they're attending an Impact event. She loves working for Impact and says it's because it doesn't feel like work. This was really good. I enjoyed this a lot because it was Tessa completely out of character. So you know, you get to see a different side of the people you don't normally see on TV. So I really like when they feature these Around the Ring segments. So, you know, a face run for Tessa in the future is definitely not out of the realm of possibilities. The classic match was AJ Styles versus Christopher Daniels from Final Resolution 2009. I'm not going to get into that. And then we got a recap of last week's Impact from the main event, which was Tommy Dreamer versus Eli Drake, where Eli Drake went over thanks to an oar from a boat. I would check out this week's episode of Xplosion. It was really enjoyable, especially the match in the Around the Ring segment. That is really all I have for you guys today. I'm planning, like I said earlier on, adding Xplosion to Sunday's Impact Report along with the viewership numbers. So thanks for checking out my video, and until next time, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Thanks, guys. Bye. Did you like that video? If so, click here to check out more great content. Thank you for supporting the Clock Cleaners Podcast.